I would now like to call Mr. Karmreet Mankad, Solution Director, Huawei Telecommunication, to kindly take a seat on the dais.
Sir has over 25 years of experience in business technology management for Greenfield JV organizations for IT and telecommunication solution, product and services. He has also held key positions at Reliance Communication and Tata Telecom. Sir specializes in end-to-end solutions, process design, business case analysis, CAPEX-OPEX optimization, business opportunity identification, team building, and conflict resolution. Sir will be speaking on thought for next generation wave of growth. We welcome you, sir, to Communique 11. I would now request, sir, to preside over. I would now request, sir, to preside over the session.
Good afternoon, everyone. Dear dignitaries and friends, it is indeed my honor to be here and share my thoughts on next wave of growth for Indian telecom industry. First, let me congratulate SITM for creating such an excellent infrastructure for developing future telecom business leaders and organizing highly thought-provoking annual event for exchange of views. I was here since morning, and it is interesting the way we have interacted with each other and thought through some of the events which are happening in the telecom industry. It is very interesting to note that the event this year has been very well designed, binding together network infrastructure, network operations and applications involving cutting-edge technologies like mobile broadband, cloud computing and social media applications. We at Huawei work with vision of enriching life through communications. The seminar subjects touch upon the enablers of this vision very well, that of creating life enriching solutions like mobile finance and social media applications, host them on cloud infrastructure and deliver them through mobile broadband. The question which came into my mind was, these are the enablers that we have, but what are the differentiators that we do for the customers that we have, for the society in which we live? Well, when I was thinking through that, the answer that I got through one of our top Huawei core value, which is customer first. And the customers here are more than 70% of India's population, which lives in over 600,000 villages. While industry and government jointly ensure that the network infrastructure is made available to them, I invite the young telecom leaders assembled here to put right kind of appliances and applications in their hands. So far, broadband penetration in India has remained limited. And that drives us to believe that the next wave of growth, and rather big wave of growth, will come from this particular sector, sector which will deliver broadband connectivity to society at large, to consumers at large. Today, one of the reasons when we were debating, when I was part of the service provider team, that it is the fear of touching the computer which is inhibiting the growth of broadband. It is the fear of operating the computer, operating the computer in a written language, even if you, let us say, cross the barrier of English language, still the barrier of having a written language to interact with is something which has been kind of holding the growth of broadband. But I'm sure, thanks to the innovations carried out in the devices like tablet, where we have now user-friendly graphic interface, we can put this capability into the people who are kind of challenged in terms of written languages, and that can transform the experience. So the challenge in front of us to bring about this wave is to create devices and voice-enabled interactive applications which can transform the user experience for millions of Indians, not only rural Indians, but people who live in towns and cities, and remove them from the cycles in which they have been kind of holding themselves. We all experience the power of information every day in our lives. We are always connected to our offices, our family, and our friends, and our source of information. Imagine the transformation that we can bring through this power being made available to millions of people through user-friendly devices. I urge the future leaders to create voice as well as video-based applications, social media applications, and make difference for our fellow citizens. Let us have farm relay in an actual word being made available to our people in the rural areas. Let them have a single touch access, not only to Facebook, but to Farmbook, so that they can get access to the information that they need, the kind of enabled experience they need. The other key customer for all of us is our society. Telecom leaders can serve the society very well by pursuing green network initiatives. I am proud of the fact that at Huawei, we continue to invest into research towards highly efficient power systems and network infrastructure towards greener growth. Now, coming to the subject of cloud computing, next session we'll discuss a lot about the benefits of cloud computing which will be made available. But I would like to share the experience that we have at Huawei. We have implemented cloud for one of our large internal setup for more than 2 years now. I mean, we have been using it using our own infrastructure for our own people, and have obtained very encouraging results. We have been able to achieve more than 70% reduction in power consumption and improve the computing resource utilization over 10 times. I'm sure this distinguished panel has several such case studies and proposals to share and encourage all of us to embrace cloud computing. Finally, a few thoughts on telecom transformation as business. Next wave of growth is going to require next wave of services. We have just little bit touched YouTube kind of applications providing video services. In days to come, those services are going to be more and more popular. We have examples already in US where video is billing, professional video is billing, being delivered over broadband. The customers, more and more customers are going to use always on devices, creating challenge for our OSS, BSS systems, as was elucidated in the previous discussion. We also need to look at new business models. As one of the panelists rightly pointed out, we are still using old generation business models for new generation services, which will not kind of And hence, that is kind of restricting the growth of data services. We need to move away from kind of luxury, data being considered luxury, to data being considered commodity. And other industries have done that. If you think of airline industries, they have made airline travel very, very popular by adopting completely different business model. Think of the automobiles. Automobile industry, of course, Nano is the extreme kind of example, but automobile industry has also made sure that the benefits reach to a wider section of the society and don't remain limited to a smaller section of the society. Our third customers are our service providers. We at Huawei take pride in serving our service providers by remaining in step with them in understanding their requirements and understanding their business plans and developing products and services towards that. And I'm sure the business leaders coming out from this esteemed institute will help us do that more and more as we march towards that particular goal. We at Huawei consider the business challenge as A, B, C business challenge. A for ARPU, ARPUs are going down. B for bandwidth, bandwidths are going up. And C, the cost. The cost need to be controlled. And it is the ABC business model that we need to work together with service providers to make them successful. We at Huawei take pride in being leader in almost all the kind of subjects that we have today. We are leader in TD, LT space. We already launched our professional network in Poland. We are already leader in cloud computing. And we have end-to-end flexible business support systems, which are for the next generation. I mean, there used to be days when a new product or services takes months to come from concept to the market. Now, with flexible BSS, it's possible to make them available almost instantaneously. Finally, I would like to urge the young leaders that they should think of innovation, innovation, innovation. Have entrepreneurship ingrained into whatever they do, be they a part of an organization or on their own. Let them be entrepreneur first, and then the anything else. And develop EQ, emotional quotient, to understand our customers, to understand the requirements, empathize with them, and continue to create the next wave of growth, which is really required for India to become a completely, seamlessly connected broadband world. That's all from my side. Thanks.
Thank you, sir, for sharing with us your experience and insight on next generation wave of growth and enriching lives. Indeed, we need better devices and voice-enabled applications to transform user experience.
I now invite my colleague to felicitate Sir with a memento as a token of our gesture.
Thank you, sir. I would now request you to kindly take your seat amongst the audience.